and to play his recognition tune since 1926, which he continued to play till his death 1974. We are going to do for you E. St. Louis Toodle-oo. Many types of blues. The blues is a sort of situation in the mind where you don't know what's right and what's left and what's back and what's forward. I have to apologize for my English. My Russian is much better, I must say. But what to do about that? Anyhow, I talked about blues, and when in November 1924, Louis Armstrong came to the famous orchestra of Fletcher Henderson, the first number recorded by Louis Armstrong with that famous orchestra was a piece which is called The Meanest Kind of Blues. And in our midst we have a young man, he comes from Hungary, he can't help it of course, and he will have to play for a number of taps. He has to play a long high C, and so we all are praying that he will fulfill that thing. We are going to do for you the meanest kind of blues with the help of Mr. Peter Iwan on cornet. Yes. Music of the time, and so if you feel some tension in your legs or in some other parts of your body, don't hesitate and start dancing. It will be a pleasure for us to accompany you. Talking about physical properties, dear ladies and gentlemen, when people are getting 40, some people are saying, now you're getting old, now you're not looking fine, etc. That's absolutely not true. Look at us. We are together about 670 years old, and it doesn't help so much, I can tell you. Anyhow, it's not true that when you are getting 40 or above 40, then everything is over. No, only the difference is that what you earlier called ugly, now you call beautiful, and what you called earlier beautiful, you say it's ugly. So we are going to do a piece which in the 20 in the years 20 already was written for Broadway, and it's called 40 and Tight. I would say 40 and Still Tight. Thank you. 34. It's not such a happy time anymore as in the 20s. Depression has set in, and people can dream only at home because for going out they don't have any penny. And when they dream, they think about a song like this, which has been arranged by the gentleman who is doing now this with his fingers to give the tempo. It's Mr. Ronald Jansen Heidmeier. Dear ladies and gentlemen, we are going to do Willow Weep For Me.
Green along the ground to cover me. Listen to my plea, listen, willow, weep for me. Come, my lover's dream, lovely summer dream, gone and left me here to weep my tears into the stream. Sad as I can be, sad, a willow, weep for me. Whisper to the wind and say my love has sinned, to left my heart are breaking and making a moan. Murmur to the night to hide the starry light, so none can see my crying and sighing all alone. Weeping willow tree, weep weeping sympathy. Gone and left me here to weep my tears into the stream. When the shadows fall, listen, willow weep for me.
Gentlemen, there was one orchestra which you could hear all over the United States during the night, and from the east coast to the west coast, and that was the orchestra of Coon and Sanders, and the Coon Sanders Nighthawks, and they were immensely popular because on their stage they had a sort of Wall Street ticker, and then you could request any number and they played it instantly, so that was fantastic. The piano player of that orchestra, Joe Sanders, composed the next piece, and which was played by many orchestras, and we are going to do it as well, and we hope you like it. It's a piece called Blazin'.
Thank you.
we have to return to the grandmaster of all this music, and it's of course Duke Ellington. We are going to do for you Black and Tan Fantasy, a piece which he was writing in 1926 together with his then star cornetist Mr. Gerber Miley, and we would like to do that for you as well. I must say we played that for the first time yesterday evening in Blackford-on-Avon or something. Bradford-on-Avon. So it's a premiere for Bude and a premiere for us as well. Black and Tan Fantasy, Duke Ellington. Which already was there in the 20s. Only products had a different name. For example, heroin was called brown sugar, and there are a lot of other names for the different stuffs which you could get at any point. That was observed also in on Broadway, and in from the year 1926 we are going to do a piece which is then called Brown Sugar. We have to assure you, we are not drugged, not yet anyhow, and it will be a pleasure for us to do Brown Sugar. Of agricultural offspring were both dead on his 12th year of age, so he had to rule that whole farm with all the cows and all the other pigs and you know, name it, when he was 12 alone. That's a hard sort of existence. So when he was 25 years, ladies and gentlemen, he had more than enough to do that all alone, so he thought as a wise decision, I will take a wife. But how to do that? He had no friends. In fact, he has no dog, he has no cat, he has no wife yet, I can tell you. And I must tell you the reason. So when he thought, well, I will take a wife, he thought, well, how to get acquaintance with a good wife, because he was living in a small farmer village in Holland, and then nothing is happening, as you can understand what I mean. And but then he saw in the paper marriage advertisements. Thank you. I'm not placing a marriage advertisement. He was placing a marriage advertisement because he thought that's wise, and I can get it. So he phoned the cheapest Dutch daily because it's a good restaurant. He's always looking for the cheapest bargain, of course. And so he asked, "Can I place a marriage advertisement in your paper?" Of course, he said. On which evening do you want it? Well, he said, "Well, Friday." Or Saturday, but Friday is not good because all the people are then eating fish in Holland, and I don't like fish, so better on Saturday. That's the best evening, and most lonely women will then look into the papers for a good thing. So the lady patiently at the phone of the daily said, "Well, please, can you quote me now your advertisement?" Now he said, "Well, it will be very simple. Young agrarian with a big acreage and a good farm is looking for a nice young wife to help him on his farm and to marry him, and if possible to give also some birth of some good children. And it would be helpful if that lady would also be in possession of a tractor. Those ladies who are interested are asked to send their curriculum vitae, for those who don't understand Latin. That's their Lebenslauf, and they should also accompany that letter with a passport photograph of their tractor." And of course, there were not too many answers, and as a consequence, he is still not married. But he's still optimistic, dear ladies and gentlemen, and he will sing for you "Blue Prelude." Thank you.
and blue. Let me go away from this lonely, lonely town. Won't be long till my song will be through. Cause I know I'm on my last go round. What is love? What is love but the brilliant sorrow with a heartbreak, with a heartbreak meant for you all? Here I go, now you know why I'm leaving. Got blues, what can I lose?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. To do a very early piece of Duke Ellington, ladies and gentlemen. And that's again Mr. Peter Iwan, who is playing the role of Bubber Miley. We are going to do for you Black Beauty. there were a lot of very famous and good orchestras in the 20s, dear ladies and gentlemen. One of the most famous ones is, of course, the orchestra of Fletcher Henderson. In 1926, they engraved a recording with, as first trumpeter Young, Rex Stewart, 70 years old, and they were doing a piece which was then arranged by their first alto saxophonist, Mr. Don Redman, and the piece is called Destampede, and we would like to offer that to you. Quite another atmosphere than Ellington, but as nice, we should say. Everybody's tongue, everybody is worried about bushes and animals, etc. But that's another thing of today. In the 20s also, people were very concerned, especially with the fate of the alligators in the Mexican Gulf, because they had it in 1922, they had it very difficult, as there were very few Indians to eat, and there were also very few people who deliberately threw themselves into the jaws of all those nice crocodiles, so they had a real hard time. And that was observed in Broadway, dear ladies and gentlemen. The piece was written, Alligator Crawl, 1923, in honor of the Mexican alligators in the Mexican Gulf. So let's think about them.
Thank you.
another famous royalty of jazz we have not mentioned yet, dear ladies and gentlemen. That was a piano player, and his name was Mr. Jaleroe Morton. He originated from New Orleans, where he was born in 1896. He had a very high view on himself, and rightly so, because he was a very nice piano player, very good composer, and he had very nice orchestras in the 20s and beyond. And he was so proud of himself that he wrote on his visiting card, inventor of jazz. Well, that's not absolutely true, but nevertheless, he left us some very nice pieces, and we are going to do a piece of 1926 from him, and that's called Black Bottom Stomp, and mark the clarinets and all our instruments. Once again, back to dear Duke Ellington, dear ladies and gentlemen. We are going to play a piece which is very famous, and we would like to do that for you in our way. And the piece is called The Mooch.
Thank you.
When on the 18th of January 1938, it was a very cold wintry day, you went on Fifth Avenue and you saw all those big theaters there. There was one theater which drew very much attention. It was Carnegie Hall, dear ladies and gentlemen, because that night, for the first time ever, apart from the famous Whiteman concert in 1924, a jazz orchestra, a real jazz orchestra, would give a concert in famous Carnegie Hall, where only classical concerts were given until then. And so everybody was very nervous. The public was nervous. There were a lot of famous composers and musical directors. And also the orchestra was rather nervous. The hall was sold out, 2,500 people, and the concert started. And as the orchestra was also rather impressed by that surrounding, this famous classical hall, and to play jazz in there. So everybody was, the orchestra became not loose. It's a tight ensemble, and then the usual things didn't go like it had to go. And the drummer, Gene Krupa, sought after the eighth piece, well, this is going wrong, we might lose our reputation. So he thought about one special thing. He introduced a piece on his drums, which later on conquered the whole world, and that piece was called Sing, Sing, Sing. Now we have in our midst a young gentleman, dear ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Louis de Bey, who in his early youth already started to study the work of Gene Krupa. He played with many famous orchestras in Europe and outside. In England he was very few times only with us last year, and also with one other orchestra. So he's not yet famous here, but he soon will be, because he impersonates the role of Gene Krupa in the famous piece Sing, Sing, Sing. It's Mr. Louis de Bey in Sing, 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 dear ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
dear ladies and gentlemen. Dutch Veen Compa, Mr. Rudeberg. Thank you very much, Mr. Rudeberg. Thank you very much, Mr. Rudeberg.
We have to introduce you also to our little master. It's Mr. Ronald Janssen-Heidmeier, who on alt sax would like to play happily for you a piece, and that's then called Harlem Nocturne, and please note his very intelligent way of playing. Harlem Nocturne.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was Mr. Ronald Jansen, my player. And we still once again return to New York. It's early 1930. It's a wintry morning. It's in January the 19th, in fact. And so it's icy cold, minus 30 degrees in the morning. Can be very cold in New York. And through the dark streets, a couple of silhouettes are running to the studio. And these are members of the orchestra of Duke Ellington who are going to engrave as a recording a number which became very popular in later years. And the number is Rockin' in a Rhythm, and we are going to do that for you. Duke Ellington was the last one to endure from us tonight, at least, because tomorrow we are playing again in the Falcon Hotel, I think. And we would like to thank you very much for your kind patience to listen to us. And we had much pleasure in playing for you here in Bute Haven Leisure Center. And as our traditional piece, we are going to do for you as a last piece, She Is Mine, All Mine. And as always, we would like to thank once again for all your nice and kind attention. She Is Mine, All Mine. We hope it once will become the truth for us, and we would like to see you again during these days. Tomorrow we are here, and on Monday afternoon we play also one little concert in the Heartland Hotel, and then it's to Holland again. We would like to thank you very much. Thank you. Bye bye. She is mine, all mine. Andor Jasmine of Holland. Till tomorrow.
Yeah.